Yo! We did it, brother! We did it!
I feel bad, man, for you getting up this time in the morning.
Nah, dude. No, I'll just, you know, I'm doing just fine. We're good, buddy. We're good.
Go on.
Okay, cool. All right, man, you ready?
Yeah, let's do this.
All right. Everybody, welcome to Slap Son. We got the man in the building. If you're a fan of Harry Potter, you know that he was a real spider in there, eating you alive. The man might decorate your house, but you don't want to upset him because he won't turn your walls black. He'll turn your head black. He'll turn your family down. The man is a veteran of the sport. When it came to Power Slap, they called him to make it. He made it. He was in the tryouts. Like, he made it. And now he's fighting for everything he's got. PS9 doesn't know what they're going to get. He's going against the Chief, because the Chief handled the venom. You feel me? Everybody, give it up for Darren! My man, my man. Dude, how are you? What's up?
Man, I'm good, mate. I'm feeling real good. We've put the hours in the gym. We're ready, man. We're ready. We all ready.
I love it, dude. I love it. So I gotta ask you right off the rip. Me and my boys, we've watched your match 7 or 8 times on the show.
Yeah, yeah.
What goes through your actual animal brain when your arm breaks and you can't do anything about it, man?
Man, that was obviously coming from a bare knuckle background. I mean, I've broke my hands a few times. Do you know what I mean? But yeah, that one was it was like nerve damage as well. So I'm a fighter, man. If I could have carried on, I would have carried on. But I had like nerves shooting up from my arm, man, and flipping. You've seen in the video, my hand went grey. And I had all on the other side. When I walked out, on the other side, like the inside of my palm went purple where I burst the blood vessels in my hand. Man, it was pretty bad, man. It was it was very, very painful. But you know what I mean, if I could have went on with my left hand, I would have. But yeah, man, that was bad. I think if I'd have swung my left hand, I'd have been in agony, like, so. You know what I mean? In the way I see it, it was a dirty trick, man. I think he knew what he was doing. Yeah, I mean, to be honest with you, I'd like the rematch, to be honest, because I feel like I got robbed from that knockout. Do you know what I mean? I think I could have finished him, but there we go. Do you know what I mean? Some people are built for this shit. Some people ain't.
I was gonna ask you because Pono, they let him go with the other hand, right?
Yeah, yeah.
So
at the time they did offer, but the thing is, like, I mean, the way you look at it is, you know what I mean, if I would have carried on, I still had a chance. I could have lost that fight, but I know what I mean, and I felt like I got cheated. Do you know what I mean? I don't think, I mean, if you're gonna do a dirty trick like that, you don't deserve another chance. Do you know what I'm saying? But yeah, man, I wasn't too much pain anyway, man. There was no way I wanted to swing my other arm. Do you know what I mean? With the pain that I was in at the time, it was yeah, it was, and I was fucking fuming, man. I was fuming.
But dude, you can feel it through the screen.
I don't think I'd have fucking hit him with a punch, let alone a slap. Man.
No, dude, you could. I was saying you could sense it through the screen because, like, people need to understand about the sport that it is actually just as important as your opponent to keep his shit together.
Oh,
because,
man, it could be dangerous. Do you know what I mean? At the moment, at these lower rankings and stuff like that. Do you know what I mean? We're earning good money, but it's not. You know what I mean? Life changing. We still got to go to work at the moment. Do you know what I mean? It's like, you know what I mean? You don't want to be going home fucking having to have, like, do you know what I mean, weeks off work. Do you know what I mean? I was put out for a couple of weeks. Do you know what I mean? It wasn't good.
No, not at all. And it's like, yeah, it's funny. This comes up a little bit through these conversations where. I'm a huge MMA nerd, right? So my first fight was Couture Liddell 3. And back in the day in that sport, and it's connected because Dana White's connected to Slap, right? But back in the day, dude, those boys were paying for their flights. They had 2 jobs. Like, it was legit. And now, even with you guys getting taken care of a little bit better, people need to understand, even the competitors, yo, this is my livelihood, son. No, don't bend your head. Don't dip your neck. You know what I mean?
Now, I do. I will give it to Power Slap, man. They do look after us, and obviously, when I landed back in the UK, they sent me down the right paths, and we got it sorted pretty quick because obviously they wanted me on the Abu Dhabi card. So yeah, it got dealt with, and yeah, the recovery was pretty quick. So yeah, yeah, hands down, Parasap is good man for things like that. So yeah, I appreciate them for that.
Yeah, absolutely. And to keep in mind that, you know, they need to be, you need to take care of each other up there, even though you're trying to kill each other, you know, kill each other in a sense, right?
Yeah, that's it, man. That's it. If he dies.
Dude, I love it. It's so crazy. So tell me about Chief. What do you know about him, man? What's coming up with it?
Man, I can't say a bad word about that guy, man. I like him. I mean,
he's so humble, bro.
I'm not really a trash talker anyway, bro. Do you know what I mean? I've always been. I mean, I'll let him do the talking when we get up on stage. But I'm not gonna badmouth Chief, man. I like him. I love Pono, man. I think they're great people, man. I actually got quite a lot in common with Chief. So we had a good couple of conversations and that. Do you know what I mean? He wants it. You know what I mean? He wants it just as much as I do. Do you know what I mean? You can't blame a man for that. Do you know what I mean? So, mate, me and Chief's gonna be a war, man. I can see it, man. I really do think we got fight tonight on our hands here. Do you know what I mean? None of us are gonna wanna stay down. I know that for a fact. Do you know what I mean? It's just not built in our DNA. But mate, this is gonna be a war, man. I'm looking forward to it, man. I really am, man. I love this shit.
No, I think your match. We in this house, we think that's the sleeper. People know who you guys are, but they're looking for Machine and Isaiah. They're looking for the Dumpling and Crazy, and that's cool and everything. But there's always that fight on a card that is kind of the sleeper, and you guys are gonna have a fucking war. I am pumped, dude.
Trust me, we both wear our hearts on our sleeve. Do you know what I mean? We both got that warrior mentality. We've both been in combat sports for many years. Do you know what I mean? And none of us wants to take a L. Do you know what I'm saying? So. Man, this is going to be fireworks, man. This is going to be fireworks. It's going to be a good fight, man. And I know there's a lot of fans out there already getting in contact with me and stuff like that. And do you know what I mean? Telling me how excited they are for the fight, which is nice. Like, do you know what I mean?
Yeah, absolutely. When do you head out there?
I come out on the 19th.
The 19th. Okay, so they give you some time.
Yeah, got a bit of time. Obviously, you know what it's like. You get pulled pillar to post for a few days with all of the stuff you've got to do with the media and stuff like that. But yeah, hopefully I'll get a bit of time to have a little look around. Yeah, meet up with some of the lads from the house. Do you know what I mean? It'd be nice to see some of the brothers. Do you know what I mean? So we got very close. Like, do you know what I mean? All living together. It'd be nice to see some of the lads again.
Yeah, for sure. Is it does that house really do create bonds, or is it just kind of like, dude, I want to, you know, it's just too chaotic?
Man, I think when you're in that house, you know what I mean, and you're all under one roof, I think it's hard not to. Do you know what I mean? Even like my opponent Dale, like, do you know what I mean? I got very close to that dude. Do you know what I mean? I felt a little bit sad after the fight. Like, do you know what I mean? But it is what it is. But yeah. Obviously, me and you spending that much time with the guys, you know what I mean? I created some great friendships in there, man. And I'm staying in touch with some of the lads, do you know what I mean? We keep in touch and stuff like that. Like, do you know what I mean? And I'll always support them, man. I want to see all of these guys make it.
Dude, that's fantastic. Yeah, looking at it, it was like even the power of a show like that where they can edit and do things like this and make things look a certain way. You knew it wasn't as crazy because each episode, it wasn't drama after drama. It was almost like they had to create something, you know. Yeah. I mean, of course, there's guys, you know, dropping pants and making threats, but like that wasn't really, that really wasn't the norm. You know what I mean?
Yeah, I was still way too close to that bloke when he dropped his pants.
Dude, what goes through a dude's mind to be like, first I got to get naked and then I'm going to slap him?
I think it was like the first day we went in the house, the second day, and I was like, yo, man, this shit's going to be crazy.
That is like, he made a first impression, no doubt. No, dude, I love it. So it's just cool. It's cool to hear that, like, it takes something that wild to make it a quote unquote reality show. So you could tell that the boys were like, you know, giving up information and cheering people on. And even after matches, they're saying, I love you and things like that. And people need to see that side of the sport. You know what I mean?
And I tell you, mate, there was some good friendships bonded in that house. And then, you know, I mean, they've had to take each other's heads off. Do you know what I mean? But I mean, everyone in that house had that warrior mentality, so they knew. You know what I mean, you could be friends, but you know what I mean, as soon as it was time to switch on, do you know what I mean? It's your friendship's gonna have to go out the window just for the fight. Do you know what I mean? After, is what I mean. Is what I'm trying to say.
Yeah. No, for sure. In that moment, it's 3 minutes of hell, and you just gotta do it.
Of course, man. I've always been able to do that as well. Do you know what I mean? With previous fights as well, I've been able to stay in. Do you know what I mean? To stay in be pally with them before. Like, do you know what I mean? And as soon as it comes to walking out time, do you know what I mean? Be able to just switch the game up and think, well, I hate this bloke now, and I'm gonna smash his teeth out. You know.
Yeah, it's a quick warrior mentality, no doubt, dude.
Trust me,
no doubt.
You know what I mean?
So with your career, the fighting career, so we saw the highlights in Bare Knuckle and some other things. I don't want to ask you what's different or what's better or whatever. What I want to ask you about it is, when you get slapped and you feel a little wobbly, as opposed to getting knocked down, like say 3 times and having to get back up, do you have to dig deeper in Bare Knuckle to get up as in Power Slap, or is it about the same? Like inside, you got to dig, and which one's worse?
If you want my honest opinion, I haven't even been rocked in Power Slap yet. I haven't hit.
Okay.
I haven't even come close to hitting the floor. So, no disrespect to my opponents. I think I'm giving myself the credit for that. I think my chin's quite pretty good. Like, do you know what I mean? I've been hit with some big heavy shots. I think one that Dell hit me with actually like spun my head for a couple of seconds. But there was no point where I thought, man, I'm gonna hit the floor. But do you know what I mean? You never say never, man. In this crazy sport, it don't really matter who you are. Do you know what I mean? Everyone's got a button, and if you hit it right, do you know what I mean? There's a possibility that everyone's gonna go down. Do you know what I mean? Chief brings some crazy power, but I'm not planning on making an habit of it in the floor and slap.
No, bro, I hear you.
We've worked on a few things. You know what I mean? We've worked on a few things just to make sure we stay on our feet. So I'm opening the payoff.
What about so like when I don't eat for a while, I get lightheaded, right? How does diet and what do you drink play into that match? Do you want to get jacked with caffeine? Like what keeps your body full?
Nah, I don't really think of anything like that, to be honest.
Okay.
Yeah, no, mate, I'll just go out and do it.
You just go out and do it. It's a too detailed of a question. Let's get back to having fun.
As soon as I've hit weight, man, I'll just get some decent food in me, stay hydrated. I mean, I think staying hydrated is the most important thing when you're taking headshots anyway. Do you know what I mean? You don't want a dehydrated brain when you're taking shots. So, yeah, I mainly concentrate on keeping hydrated, to be honest with you.
Dude, that brings up a good point. Like, with the weight cut in other sports, you have some time to get developed, but you're using more your whole body. Being dehydrated in slap is probably the thing to avoid.
I think it's the most important thing is to stay hydrated, definitely. You know what I mean? Obviously, you're dehydrating your brain. Obviously, it's gonna make it easier for you to get knocked out. So, but I'm pretty good with my weight, to be honest. I've kept on top of it. I like to stay a couple of pounds over, and then I'll just lose the last couple of pounds before weighing.
Yeah, that's smart. So you're not killing yourself the week before.
Yeah, I'm basically where I want to be now. I'll just keep tweaking weight now until I get there, and then we'll just get the last couple of pounds off when we're there.
Dude, I love that. I love that. So growing up in Bristol, man, what kind of music were you into, bro? Or was music your thing? What were you into, man?
I was into
besides drugs, women, and rock and roll. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, a bit of that. Without the rock and roll, I used to listen to grunge. But to be honest, I'm pretty old school, mate. To be honest, I'm quite. I got brought up with all old school music and stuff like that. Like I'm a massive fan of like Motown and. Do you know what I mean?
Oh no, shit! You're my man. Yeah. I got made fun of growing up. I was into all that girly R&B shit.
Yeah, man. I've never really been into R&B. I'm like more and more into like the soul sort of stuff. Do you know what I mean? All the old Motown songs. I used to like Gene Pitney. I don't know if you know who he is.
Oh, I do, man. I do. I got you.
But yeah, other than that, I like reggae music, man. I love my reggae music. Yeah, pretty old school, mate. I am.
Pretty old school. You hit that Bob Marley movie?
Oh, I love that movie, man. That was good.
It was good, right?
Have you seen it?
Dude, oh, I've seen it twice.
Yeah, I
I
thought
didn't know.
that brilliant.
Yeah, it was so good. I was gonna say I didn't know that's how it went down. I thought he got I honestly thought he got assassinated. I
No,
didn't.
I didn't know the story, to be honest with you. But yeah, it was interesting to know how it really went down, wasn't it?
Oh, it totally was.
Brilliant. The film was brilliant.
It made me think, it legit made me think about life a little bit in that, he probably could have survived, but he probably was just done, dude. You know what I
Yeah,
mean?
that's it, my man. Yeah, that's it.
Your wife, your new wife,
Yeah.
dude, two fighters in the house? What's up, brother? That's amazing.
Yeah, I know, man. It's crazy, isn't it? She actually came over on the from the triax. She actually had two fights when we was over there for the triax. So most of us had one fight, but Dana was pretty impressed with her with the first one, and she got drafted in for another fight. So, but obviously we just had a little baby, so she's been out of action for a while. But keep pushing the slap team, and I'm gonna get her back over. And do you know what I mean?
Dude,
I want us to be the first slap couple, first champions. You know what I mean? It'd be
oh,
great.
for sure, man. So how was the baby, if you don't mind me asking?
Oh, she's beautiful, my man. She's beautiful. Yeah, she's 12 weeks old now.
Oh my gosh, she's still brand new.
11 weeks. She's 11 weeks old. And yeah, man, she's good, man. She don't cry, she don't do anything. We got very lucky.
Oh my God, thank God. Isn't your
Yeah.
first one?
No, it's actually my fourth.
No way. So are you all girls?
No, I've got two girls, two boys.
Oh my God, I love it. I always wanted to have a girl and I make boys. I got three boys.
Oh, no way.
Yeah, dude.
No,
There's no ladies in the house besides the wife.
oh, my girls ain't ladies.
Oh,
They're all
that's right. This is late night. Mine's not either. Don't touch her in the wrong way. She'll beat you, man.
No one messes with my daughter, brother. Trust me, she's a man.
I love it. I always joke, if I did have a daughter, she can't do anything until she's a blue belt in jiu-jitsu. Then she can go do whatever she wants.
Trust me. Yeah. Now, I try to teach them all how to look after themselves, put it that way. Do you know what I mean?
Dude,
Yeah.
so cool. What's up with the business, man? The decorated business.
Decorated business. Yeah, I've got a little decorated business. Been doing decorating on and off most of my life, to be honest with you. But obviously, when I start taking on more fights and stuff like that, I sort of put it on the back burner, but then I pick it back up in, you know what I mean, in my spare time. But yeah, my business is it's doing really well, to be honest. Got plenty of work on that at the moment. Can't grumble. But I also do a bit of working with children as well as a support worker.
No kidding.
Yeah, I do a bit of support work as well. So when I'm not painting and decorating, I like to I got a, there's a home that I work at, and I help and support the kids.
Dude, I love that. Very cool. Yeah, we're in this house, we're entrepreneurs too. So we've had a couple businesses, sold a couple, and have a little hair extension line and things like that. So I know what you're going through on the days it's coming. Bills and all that kind of stuff, payroll. I feel you, man.
I think as a man, I mean, you take it on your own back, don't you, to be a provider. So you know what I mean, yeah, I keep a lot of things going, you know what I mean, and make money whatever way I can.
Yeah, absolutely. And slapping ain't a bad way to make it.
Oh,
It's not bad.
good money, easy money.
Easy money, that's right. That's the confidence. So
Yeah.
what's up, man? We do Abu Dhabi. What's next? You go in, say it goes the way you want. Do you have a long time off, or do you want to get back in there for the 6th of
Oh,
December?
rest. We keep going. We keep going, man. Yeah. Listen, if they want to put me in 10 shows next year, I'll do 10 shows. You know what I mean? I mean, I'll fight every day of the week. Don't bother me. Not one little bit.
Dude, and I love that they just did that partner with the partnership with Fontainebleau.
It's crazy. Man, I think every time I look there, they've, you know what I mean, they've got something else going on. Man, it's so big. It's absolutely unreal, isn't it? This is. I can't really believe it. Like, how big it's got so fast. It's mad.
No, it's crazy. Well, with the Fontainebleau stuff, we're stoked because now we can go to all of them because we can go to Miami and Vegas like that, where Abu Dhabi's kind of like, eh, we can't go that far, you know? But you're right. It's growing like mad. We talked to so many guys. Everyone's so awesome, giving us their time and being good to my boys and things like that. But it's weird to think we're only coming up on nine. Nine.
I know.
And it's everyone knows whether you like it or not. This is what I say, man. I don't drink Coca-Cola. I hate Coke. For whatever reason, I don't like it, but they're doing okay. They don't give a shit that I don't like it. No. And Power Slot's the same. They don't give a shit that you don't like it. They're on the ninth event and everyone knows it exists. It's crazy.
Well, man, the numbers they're hitting is absolutely unreal, man. I mean, every time I look, I mean, I see some certain videos and I'm like, mate, I mean, how many eyes have seen this now around the world? It's absolutely crazy. It blows my mind.
Even like our boy King DeFrank, he even posts the match that he lost because it gets so many eyeballs.
Yeah, trust me, man. Yeah, the other day I think with Power Slap, do you know what I mean? I think it's going to be hard for anyone to keep a totally clean record. Do you know what I mean? Because like I said, do you know what I mean? It only takes it to hit on the button, doesn't it? So do you know what I mean? I mean if you lose one, do you know what I mean? You just got to take. Literally take it on the chin. I mean, I'll post it. You know what I mean, it is what it is. You know what I mean? You just come back, redeem yourself, and you just take the next man out, don't you?
Yeah, I mean, it really is a true test of a man because you're naked, bro. Like, it's just, you got to take the shit.
Well, it's wild, man. You know what I mean? You actually stand up, put your hands behind your back. It's like,
it's crazy.
For that split second, you think, what the fuck am I doing? You do. Just for that split second, it's like, you know what I mean? It's like, well, it's, you know what I mean? It's just, I can't defend myself, man. It's fucking, this shit's wild. But, mate, it gives all new, do you know what I mean? That all new adrenaline, do you know what I mean? It's like, fucking, I mean, that whole new test. Do you know what I mean? You are literally testing your fucking chin to the, you know what I mean, the best of his ability. Do you know what I mean? It gives you an all new buzz for me, and it's like, man, I love it.
And I've heard a lot, but for you, is it just getting through that first slap and then it's game on?
Trust me, once I felt that first one, I know exactly how it's going to go down. I know. And as soon as I've said that first one, if it don't rock me, I know I'll take them all.
Oh my God, I love that, dude. Dude, you're giving me chills. It's got to be so like exhilarating to get up there and be like, I'm taking this fool out.
There's no buzz like it, brother. Honestly, it's crazy.
Dude, it's very cool. I am so pumped for your match with Chief. You have no idea. I've got to know, I mean, you a little bit now and Chief a little bit, and it just makes you, like, honestly more attached to, like, because the passion's coming out for both your boys. You're like, holy shit, what's going to happen? I'm so pumped, dude.
There's a lot, like I said, with me and Chief, man, there's a lot of passion. I mean, we are the original Warriors. Do you know what I mean? We've been doing this many years, and Bob, it's gonna be a bloodbath. It's gonna be crazy, and this me and Chief knows what's gonna go down. I mean, I'm gonna love him before, I'm gonna love him after, but as soon as we step on that stage, we're gonna be the Warriors that we are. It's as simple as that.
Dude, I love it. Okay, before we go, obviously my boys are asleep, but they got questions for you. Sure. So the first one, this is for my 15-year-old.
Yeah.
And he said, I want to know when he becomes champ, what's the first big purchase he's going to do?
Oh, I don't know. Let me think. Do you know what? Me and the wife was talking a couple of weeks ago. We'd like a little place in America.
Oh, no shit.
Yeah, I'd like to come over and I spend a bit more time. I mean, I love America. Every time I go over, man, I absolutely love the place. So yeah, it'd be nice to have our own little place over there, our own little getaway. Do you know what I mean? So yeah, I think I'd buy a little property in America. Yeah.
Do you know whereabouts? Like warmer climate, or have you even thought about it?
Yeah, definitely warmer climate. Do you know what I mean? I've said this to a few lads in the house, and obviously they're all from different areas, so they've all like, "Oh, come to my area, come to my area." But yeah, I'd have to have a look around. But I mean, I've spent a bit of time in Vegas now. I quite like Vegas, so maybe there.
Yeah, it's cool. We actually we lived in Vegas for 4 years. We loved it.
Yeah, man, it's a good place. I mean, what I've been there a few times now, and yeah, I really enjoy it every time I'm there.
That's cool. Well, so that's weird because it leads right into my youngest son. He's 10. His question was, were you always going to live in the UK or would you find yourself in the States? So maybe we'll take that a little bit further.
Yeah. No,
And just.
I definitely like to move to the States, man. I think, I mean, I think there's definitely more opportunities and all things like that. Do you know what I mean? And I mean, the conversation's been brought up in my family now, and yeah, they've all agreed with me. It'd be nice to have a place to live over there as well. Yeah, so yeah, it's
Dude.
definitely thinking about.
Dude, I love it. Well, hey, thank you so much for your time, man.
No
The
problem, my
energy is
friend.
always so good. We're so pumped.
Anytime.
We started this crazy journey at PS8, and I say it on my YouTube channel on a whim. We just wanted to start a podcast,
Yeah,
and next thing you know, we're growing, bro, and we're having the
man,
time of our
you guys are
life.
great. You guys are great, man. You keep doing what you're doing, man. We all appreciate you guys, man. You're brilliant.
Okay, thank you so much, brother. I appreciate it. We'll do it again really soon.
Take it easy, my man.
Okay, one sec here.